Okay. Hi, Scorpio. Let's find out what the message is for you today in the current moment. Oops. I'm just going to shuffle the cards. What, my readings are not date specific or time specific. They're you versus them scenarios, and they can apply at any given moment in space, time, that you felt guided to this channel by spirit. Now I feel like it's this card over here. Oh shit. It's a bit aggressive, Scorpio. We've got the most aggressive energy coming out. So let's see what energy is coming through for you with this energy. I always like have to take a double take when this card come out, because look at the energy. Someone is like very possessive of you, Scorpio. Someone's very triggered. Like, this is an energy of jealousy, possessiveness. Yeah, it's like someone is in this energy towards you, and I feel like they're jealous of the thought of you moving on. So let's see what energy wants to come through with this guy, because he's very he's very triggered and he's very, very possessive. Scorpio, you've triggered someone. What have you triggered in this person? Okay, I feel like it's this energy. Mental prison. Okay, Scorpio, you've got a masculine energy. I feel like this is a masculine energy coming through, because it's such possessive energy. It's not gender specific, but I feel like, Scorpio, you are dealing with, or you are the Panther. And the Panther is a very possessive masculine energy. Now, I feel like you have ended a relationship with this masculine. We have the energy of death. Now, this is a connection that has died. It has died. It is over with, this cycle. And I feel like, you know, when you ended this connection, or you detached, or you let go from this masculine, it triggered this Panther to come out. I don't think this masculine ever thought he would lose you. I don't think he thought you'd ever let go. I think he thought you'd be waiting around for him forever. And when you decided to walk away, let go, and let God, this masculine felt this wave of triggers that came through, and he's in a mental prison over losing you, because he can't stop thinking about the situation and what happened. And I just think he's shocked that he's lost you. So I don't think it's a masculine who ever thought he would lose you. He's feeling very triggered over losing you. He is very triggered at the thought of you moving on with somebody else, because he's very possessive and jealous. So I think because you've let go, you've walked away, he's sensing that you could be moving on, and it's triggering jealousy, it's triggering insecurity. So that's the first message that wants to come through for you, Scorpio. Have you let go of someone recently? Closed out a cycle? Because that's what's coming up for you. Okay, so we have a feminine energy. This is your energy, Scorpio. It's coming up as a peacock. She's very unimpressed. Very unimpressed with her Panther. And quite rightly so, because she's closed out this cycle with him. So whatever this Panther did, however he's behaving, he was very unimpressive towards his peacock. So the peacock closed the cycle, ended the connection, because she's very beautiful. And she was very unimpressed by the masculine. So she decided it's time to let go. It's time to move on. I want someone who's going to impress me. So I feel like you got a very beautiful feminine energy here. Very beautiful, very delicate. And she is definitely not impressed by this masculine's attitude. And I think she, you know, is a high value woman, and I think she's quite beautiful. And I feel like with Lace the Moon's daughter's energy, she's like some type of earth angel here. You've got a very pure, innocent and sweet soul who's very kind and a high value woman. And I think the masculine here really unimpressed this earth angel, because he was in his shadow side. And we have Lisa the Shadows. So this masculine is embodying a lot of shadow energy here, and he wouldn't get out of his shadow side. So your shadow side is the parts of you that are, you know, are it's like underneath the false mask. It's the shadow component when you make choices out of fear. So this masculine is constantly in his shadow, in his ego, in his pride. And he was choosing the lower energies. And so she was really unimpressed that this masculine hasn't done his shadow work, hasn't done his healing, was in his ego, was playing mind games, was really toxic towards her. And she just decided it's time to move forward. I can't deal with this energy anymore. This masculine has a lot of healing to do. He's very dark. He's in his shadow side. He hasn't done his shadow work. And we've got a spiritual earth angel here who can see this masculine's shadow. She can see his light, and she saw the panther. And she's like, that's not very high vibe. That's quite aggressive energy. Do I want to be around this aggressive energy? Do I want to be around this person that can't be nice to me? Do I want to be around this person who acts like this? It's not very impressive. I'm not very impressed by his behavior. And she's kind of just like, I need to close this cycle out. I want to be around higher vibrational men. I want to be a high value woman with a high value man. And this masculine energy is not acting high value. He's acting very toxic. He's acting very dark. He's in his shadow energy. And she's like, he needs to do a lot more maturing, growing up. What is the connective energy? Very unimpressed feminine anyway is where we're going with that. Well, there's three connective energies. We have Giselle, we have Moth, we have Tiger. So the connective energy, right? I think the feminine is in her feminine energy now. And she's sitting in the Giselle's energy. And I think the Moth energy... I think that this masculine drained a lot of this feminine's light, her good energy. And so she's sitting in receptive energy now. And I think both of you recognize it's up to the masculine to pounce on her and come forward, you know, because she's like the prey and he's the hunter. So I feel like what's happened is, like, the feminine wasn't very impressed that this masculine was draining her energy and taking from her. So he was taking her light, taking her love for granted and not giving anything in return. And, you know, she's now just sitting in her feminine energy like, I'm not stepping a toe in your direction. You know, I'm not moving towards you. I'm closing this pattern and cycle out, not allowing you to take any more of my beautiful energy or my love, you know, without offering me more, without reciprocation. You know, she's not receiving the attention, affection, love, or time that she deserves. And I think the masculine and her both are recognizing it's up to him to initiate a movement, you know, move towards her. So that's the situation. So what action does this panther, who's very triggered and possessive, want to take towards the peacock? So the firefly is the card of reconciliation. He wants you back. So the masculine wants to take the energy of trying to get you back, trying to reconcile, because you guys have a powerful connection. And I feel like the masculine's recognizing he wants you back, but he's coming through the shadow energy, which is the feline. So this masculine cowered away from this connection. He was in and out of your life because he was caught in his ego and his pride. So he was definitely in his shadow side, and the feminine is accurate with what she is saying. This masculine was in fear. He was running away from the connection. He would come back and then he would run away. So it was like an avoidant attachment, and then he would get in his ego. So what was this masculine doing when he was in his ego? Have divine union and rise above. So I feel like he thought he was more powerful than this divine union, more powerful than God, more powerful than this connection. So he was trying to control this union. So clarify what that means. So I think he thought he could fight his feelings and escape this divine union. But a new cycle has started where he's recognizing vulnerability as power. So I think he thought he could fight his feelings. I think he thought he could, you know, resist this connection. Why did the masculine think he could resist this connection? He thought he could just move on from his feelings. But he's recognizing now that you two are divine counterparts and that you have a connection of unconditional love and that this connection made him really happy. So why did he want to move on from the connection? Because you're very pure and innocent, divine feminine. And he destroyed the connection. He sabotaged the connection. And he hurt you. And I don't think this master was sure how to fix things. And you wanted commitment. And he's in a lot of regret for the way that he handled the connection. And I think you were the mirror that he didn't want to face. You were like, he thought that moving on, discarding you, forgetting you would be easy. Easier than facing himself. And every time he thinks about his behavior, he gets in this energy of sadness. So it's a masculine who thought he could just ghost you and basically forget his feelings for you. It's very, very cruel. You can't ghost people that you care about or love because you're too immature to face yourself and how you treated someone. So instead of like realizing that he has a lot of issues, he thought it would be easier just to block you out of his life. Because he thought in his narrow mind that you're the problem. But he's gonna have all these same problems in every other relationship that he enters into. So he'll never be able to move on until he fixes himself, until he heals, until he does the shadow work. Because this is within this masculine soul, this problem. So now that you're moving on, his soul and his feelings and his heart are triggered because he's in love with you. And he thought he could just get over all these feelings. And this is where he's at now with all his feelings for you. And he wants you back. So why does the masculine want to reconcile with you after being so shadowy? Shit. Well, you're his dream girl. And he still has faith and hope. I feel like he's been studying everything in detail and he wants to be better, but he's just still not sure exactly how to win you back. So he wants you back, but he's like, how do I fix this? So what action does this panther want to take towards you? He wants to love you. So this is a masculine who's ascending. Let's clarify this. You're this masculine's angel. We have the earth angel. He wants to love you now. He misses you and he wants you back. So I think this masculine's recognizing you're his angel and he wants to love you. And he's feeling very possessive over you because you've broken free with the freedom's energy. I just think this masculine wants another chance because he wants to be present. and he wants to come into union with you. So I think he recognizes you're his angel, and he wants to come into union with you and be more present and show up in the connection. So he wants another chance at this, and he wants to be better. So that's the situation here. Let's find out what your guidance is moving forward. If you're resonating with the message, the link is below in the description box. To the extended reading, you can follow me over to Vimeo, where you can access the reading individually, or you can join my Patreon page for an entire month at a discounted rate. I really appreciate your energy exchange. It keeps me on YouTube full time. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye, Scorpio.